that's what we do with a framework like Vue, and that's why we often the final picture with the dynamic placeholders, you could say, and we don't define all the steps of getting that picture onto the screen. That's what we do with a framework like Vue, and that's why we also typically say that Vue uses a declarative approach. We just declare our goal, we don't care about the steps of getting there. Now it's time to practice this. So now that we got some basics about Vue.js out of the way, it's time to practice it. Attached, you find this starting project. It's, again, three files, some styles, which you don't have to worry about right now, an index.html file with some instructions, to which I'll come back in a second, and an empty app.js file, which is, of course, the place where you should write your code later. Now, in index.html, you see the instructions. On the right side, you see the running application, if you want to call it like this, but of course, a lot of logic is missing there. Your first task is to output your name here. The second task is to output your age here. And of course, you should not just add your name here like this. Instead, you should use Vue.js and maybe some cool syntax you learned about to store your name in the Vue instance and output it with some Vue syntax here. And the same for the age. The same here for the age, plus 5. And thereafter, it's time to output a random number. Now, we haven't done this before, but you can use a regular JavaScript method for generating a random number between 0 and 1. And I want you to output this random number here in this place. As a little extra challenge, try to output it here in two different ways. One time using a method, which you call, and the other time not doing so. If you're not sure what I mean, you can just watch my solution, of course, then. But again, if you have some idea, try it in two different ways.
Otherwise,
at least use one way of outputting a random number here. Task number 5 is that you should output an image here, and I want you to simply go to Google or any similar provider and search for some random free-to-use image URL and output the image here, but of course, again, not by just throwing in some image URL here. Instead, again, you should store that URL in the Vue instance and then make sure you fetch it from there and output it with some Vue syntax. And the same here for this input. I want you to pre-populate the input field by setting the value attribute. And again, of course, by doing that with some Vue features to set it to a value you will store in your Vue instance. Now that's it. These are your tasks.
Okay.
grid. A digital frontier. I tried to picture clusters of information as they move through the computer. What did they look like? Ships, motorcycles. Were the circuits like freeways? I kept dreaming of a world I thought I'd never see. And then, one day, I got it. We'll be right back.
So now we know how to output data. In modern web applications, that's only half of what you do, though. You also need to react to user input. You need to events. You want to make dynamic pages. After all, this is one of the main reasons for using a framework like Vue. It makes building highly reactive and dynamic web applications easier. Therefore, that's what we're going to focus on next. And attached, you find a simple starting project, which is not too different from the one before. We just have a slightly different content. Still got a section with a different ID now. And in there, we got two buttons, add and remove. We also have a paragraph where I output a counter, which is managed in this Vue app, which is created for you already. It's a very simple Vue app here, as you can tell. Pretty empty, just has...
Okay. Add will increase the result. Remove will be... Decrease or reset? Okay, let's do both.
This data method where I return my data, which only consists of a counter in the end, which is a number starting at 0, and I mount this to the events section, which is this section that holds all that markup. Now, at the moment, those buttons don't do anything. If I press them, you'll see that, well, nothing happens. And that's exactly what we want to work on. I want to show you how you can react to user input and how you now can really leverage Vue to make a more interactive and reactive web application. Let's say when this button, the add button, when this button is pressed, we want to add 1 to the counter. When the remove button, or reduce maybe, when the reduce button is pressed, we want to deduct 1 from the counter. Let's start with the add button. How could we do that? In regular JavaScript, we would get access to the button with doc.
Okay, in vanilla JavaScript, what we should damn, many things. First of all, we need to select the button. We need to select the results element. We need to add event listener to the button as click. Give it a function. That function will increase the result. And result dot text content, text context gonna be that number.
We would get access to the button with document get element by ID if that button had an ID, or with query selector and selecting the first button we find. Mm-hmm. And we could add an event listener with the add event listener method. That is how we would do it in vanilla JavaScript with.
You know what, I will do that. Let's button add, let button remove, let button insert, reset, let result. Fuck, they don't even have ID, right? You know what? Forget about the ID. Let's make it with query selector. Query selector. Button. NTH child 1. Remove 2. 3. Let result. Result text content parsing result text content plus 1 click minus 1. Yes, forget about this. So basically, we are doing this instead of this. Where is my mind? Okay.
without Vue. But we're using Vue so that we don't have to do it like this, so that we don't have to define step by step what should happen, but that we instead can leverage this declarative approach and just declare our end result and let Vue figure out how to get there. And therefore, thankfully, Vue gives us an easier way of adding event listeners to HTML elements. If we want to add a click listener to this button, we can use another Vue directive. We learned about vbind. Vbind is helpful for setting the value of an attribute. Now, for adding event listeners, we have another directive, and that's the vOn directive, because we want to react on a certain event. vOn takes a so-called on a certain event directive, because we want to react on a certain event. vOn takes a so-called argument after a colon, just like vbind took the attribute which should be bound. vOn takes the event to which you want to listen after the colon. In this case, click. Now, in case you're wondering to which events you can listen, well, all the default events you can listen to on HTML elements. So that would be click, mouse enter, mouse leave, really anything you can listen to in vanilla JavaScript as well. Here, it's the click to which I want to listen. And then after an equal sign between the opening and closing double quotes, we now specify the code that should run when the click occurs. And that could be counter plus plus, which is the shortest form of writing in JavaScript that we want to add one to the counter. And that's just...
Yeah, this makes me confused, because in React we are using JSX. I want to use JSX every time when I see this.
JavaScript code, nothing Vue specific. As with vbind and the double curly braces, you can have simple JavaScript expression.
Oh shit, wait. So, we don't even need methods then. He is simply doing this. Can I make it like 0? Doesn't work. It's gonna work.
Right here in your HTML code in the parts that are managed by Vue, like here with vOn. If I now save that and reload, I can click add and you will see that the counter gets bigger every time I click this button, thanks to this code. Now try doing, well, basically the same, just with reducing the counter on this button. Were you successful? Well, of course, it shouldn't be too difficult. It's essentially the same code. We want to react to a click event with vOn click, and then here we just have counter minus minus, or the longer form would also work, of course. It's totally up to you what you write there. With that, you can also reduce the counter. So now we can add and reduce. And that's pretty, pretty nice. And this is how we can listen to user events in Vue. And here's one super important thing which is easy to overlook, which shows us why we use Vue and how powerful Vue is. You might notice that we don't have much code here. Some HTML code, and definitely not a lot of JavaScript code. I mean, this here is all the JavaScript code we wrote. Yet, we have two event listeners and a counter that changes, and most importantly, and easy to overlook, we got a counter that's being output here, where the page the user sees changes every time the counter changes. This minus 6 here changes to a minus 5 if I click the button. And that's not something which would normally happen in a web page. You would need to write JavaScript code that adds event listeners, changes the counter.
That is so true, though. It is really shorthand.
And then when the counter changes, reaches out to that paragraph to change the value that's showing up there. And that's exactly what Vue does behind the scenes for you. That is the core asset of frameworks like Vue. You just declare where you want to have event listeners and where you want to output values and which values Vue should be aware of. And Vue does all the rest of adding and managing those listeners, updating the counter behind the scenes, and most importantly, detecting when the counter changes and updating the parts of the real rendered page where updating is needed when that counter changes. This is what Vue does behind the scenes. This is a core feature of Vue, this built-in reactivity. It detects that the counter changes when you click a button, and it then finds the places on the page where the counter is used to update what the user sees with JavaScript behind the scenes. I'm really emphasizing this because it's so important to understand what Vue does here and hopefully why that's pretty amazing and makes our life as a developer much, much easier. Well, and that's how we can get started with events in Vue. Now let's see what else we can do with them.